could alcohol be contributing to your allergies or your histamine intolerance? Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about alcohol and histamine. So it's known that, at least in some cells, like in the stomach, alcohol can cause the release of histamine. In the stomach, that's primarily contributing to producing stomach acid, which is playing a digestive role. Now, what about in the rest of the body? Well, alcohol directly inhibits diamine oxidase, which is one of the key enzymes in neutralizing histamine and is the most important enzyme when you're talking about in the gut, which is most relevant to histamine in the foods that you eat. Alcohol also shares enzymes involved in metabolizing histamine. There are a number of enzymes that act sequentially to inactivate histamine, and some of the ones that we don't talk about as often that come after the most important ones that we talk about often, such as diamine oxidase, are actually shared with alcohol such that if you're drinking alcohol and you're also exposed to histamine, the alcohol and histamine are going to compete with one another. And the more alcohol you have, the harder it will be for you to completely clear the histamine. Now, one of the things that I noticed when I was in Greece this year, and I made a previous episode, I'll link to that in the description of this one. One of the things that I noticed was as my allergies kept getting worse and worse and worse, not only was the vitamin A concentration of my diet declining for a continuing period of time, and not only was I eating more grains and other things that maybe were playing in cheese and other things that were maybe playing a role in releasing histamine, but also I was drinking more alcohol. And I do think that the alcohol could have contributed to the development of my seasonal allergies, because remember, you kind of have a histamine bucket where any histamine from different sources are going to fill up that bucket. And if you have histamine that you're not clearing from your diet or that you're not clearing that's being released in response to allergens in your diet, then even the pollen outside may be less effectively cleared and may be adding into that histamine bucket enough to push you over the threshold to cause symptoms. So if you drink alcohol a lot and you have seasonal allergies, you might want to try moderating, reducing, or eliminating the alcohol to see if that might improve your seasonal allergies, as well as moderating, cutting down, or eliminating alcohol to help with histamine intolerance. In the next episode, I'll talk about whether there might be some benefits to consuming small amounts of alcohol.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.